So this is exceptionally hard today to speak. First thing I would like to do is I'd like for everyone to bow their heads and let's say a little prayer. Father God, help us to know that no matter what, you love us. Help us all walk through this difficult time in the valley of the shadow of death. Help us to be aware of your presence here with us today and every day in our lives. In the silence of this hour, please speak to us of eternal things, that through your love and the comfort of the scriptures, we may have hope and be lifted above our darkness and distress and into the light and peace of your presence. We ask this all in the name of your Son, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
You know, but I was trying to get everything together for this service today. I had picked out an opening scripture reading, and then when we came yesterday afternoon for the family viewing, we were given a copy of the brochure that all of y'all have been given today. When I read it and then closed it up, I closed it up to the back side. I thought it quite ironic that the scripture that I had picked out for today was the very scripture that was on the back of it. So if any of y'all would like to read it along with me, you're certainly welcome to do so. I'm going to be reading from the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. You know, that's a wonderful thing to know that my sister-in-law was saved and that she no longer is in pain. I sat with her many hours while she was in the hospital this last time. To be honest, I didn't want her to die alone. Physically alone. Because I knew spiritually she was not going to die alone. I had no doubt of that. I knew that she had a greater power that was with her there in that hospital. Yes. And I knew that come a time that last breath was going to be drawn, and her next breath was going to be holding the hand of the Lord Jesus. I'm thankful for that. I believe we've got a song now that Heather picked out that we're going to play.
Keep you out for hours in the storm.
think we can all agree that was a beautiful song. And I think we can all agree that there's not a one of us sitting in the sound of my voice today that can't relate to that song. Even Barbara herself. But you never know. God tells us that there's a time appointed for every man to die. Barbara's time has come. And I'm sure, I'm positive, that if she could do things differently, she probably would have done a lot of things differently. And I think each one of us can say the same thing. We've all made mistakes in our lives, and there's things that we would do differently. Right now, I'm going to open it up to everybody sitting here today. If they would like to say something, just stand up and speak a memory about Barbara. I'm going to open it up to anybody here. Well, if nobody has anything to say, I'm going to say a couple of things on behalf of my wife. My wife shared a memory with me and the girls yesterday. She said, "Do you know what I remember most about my sister?" I looked at her kind of strange. She said, "When we were young, she was very mean to me. She would sit on my chest and pin my arms down and spit on me." All of you that know Barbara know that that was a possibility. You have a little mean streak in her. Barbara went through a lot of things in her life. She married Ernie Winstead on June 9, 1989. He was the love of her life. Absolutely, I'm convinced that he was the love of her life. They had over 30 good years together. I won't say that there weren't some up and downs, but everybody that has a partner in life is going to have up and downs. It's how you deal with the after effects of it. I know for a fact that your mom and dad had made things right before your dad passed. I had the opportunity to speak with Ernie in the hospital when he was on his deathbed. And I made sure that Ernie had his heart right and ready to go be with the Lord. I didn't have that opportunity with Barbara when she was in the hospital because of the way that the stroke debilitated her. And I had not shared this with you girls, but I want to take the opportunity now to tell you about quite a few months ago, when my wife and I had taken Barbara to a trip to the beach. She and my wife both loved the beach. I got up early that morning about 4 o'clock to go out onto the fishing pier and get all my stuff set up and get my spot picked out before all the other king mackerel fishermen came out there. And I look around and here comes Barbara walking up the pier. There wasn't another soul on the pier that morning. My wife, any of you that know her, know that if noon comes and she's up, that can be a rarity. So Barbara walked out there. She heard me leaving. I tried to be just as quiet as I could, but she heard me leaving. And she came out there. And as I was getting everything set up and finished, I noticed that she was just sitting there staring out across the water. The sun was just beginning to rise. She was enthralled by the beauty of that sunlight. I turned finally when I had my stuff set up and I said, "It's a beautiful sunrise, isn't it? It's going to be a beautiful day." And she said, "Yes, it is." I said, "You know, Barbara, there's an opportunity there to have all of your days be beautiful. Be beautiful in eternity. She looked at me and she said, I want that. She said, because I know that's where my husband is at. She said, I know that's where my son's at. I know some of you may know that they lost a son very tragically in 2009. That was a hole in both of their hearts that could never be filled. But I'm 100% confident standing here today to say that Barbara had her heart right. The Lord was with us there in that hospital. He was with her the day that she passed on. I hope you girls can take that and be comforted by that. Jenny, I hope you can take that and be comforted by that. Now we're going to have some special music by Miss Dawn Hobbs.
Manly, while she's coming and getting ready, I couldn't open my mouth when you asked that question, but I don't want to let it go by.
What was that? I'm sorry.
I said, while she's getting ready, I couldn't open my mouth, and I don't want to let that go by, the chance, the opportunity to say something about Barbara and represent our family. My mom and dad couldn't be here, but Ernie and Barbara, that was, although they were married, he was my brother, she was my sister. I know it sounds weird, but anybody that knows us understands. And this past summer, we had an opportunity to go to our camp, our church retreat, and it's our spiritual retreat. And for whatever reason, the only people that could go were my two sisters and Barbara, and it was the four of us. And I would give nothing for that time that we had together, and we got a chance to say stuff to her and talk to her and talk about Ernie and just life and her kids, because you always talk about her kids and her grandkids. Matter of fact, Barbara never shut up. So basically, she's talking to us, except she went to sleep. But she means a lot to us and their family, and I had often told Barbara and Ernie together while they were here and look them in the face and tell them how much that they were inspiring to overcome so much tragedy and so many hard things, and that they were the two of the strongest people that I know in my life. And I love them, and to the girls and their family, we will still always be family. Don't y'all forget that.
Does anybody else have anything they'd like to say now?
And now I'm supposed to say,
you are the
daughter of Sissy. We love her so much. Tell me, what does it look like in heaven? Is it peaceful? Is it free like they say? Does the sun shine bright forever? Have your fears and your pain gone away? 'Cause here on earth it feels like everything good is missing since you left. And here on earth everything's different, there's an emptiness. Oh, I hope you're dancing in the sky, and I hope you're singing in the angels' choir. what do you do up in heaven? Are your days filled with love and light? Is there music? Is there art and adventure? Tell me, are you happy? Are you more alive? 'Cause here on earth it feels like everything good is missing since you left. And here on earth everything's different. There's an emptiness. Oh, I hope you're dancing in the sky. And I hope you're singing in the angels' choir. And I hope the angels know what they have. I'll bet it's so nice up in heaven since you arrived. Since you arrived.
Thank you, Donna, for that beautiful song. There again, beautiful music. Barbara loved music. And I have no doubt that she is dancing in the sky today. She's dancing with the angels. Ernie may get a dance every once in a while, but right now she's dancing with the angels. What I'm going to do now, take the opportunity to thank each and every one of you, family, friends, loved ones of family, for being here today. I'm sure that the family recognizes that none of you have to be here. Your presence today is a true affirmation of your love and your support. Them. Although they may not remember every word that will be shared today, they will remember your presence here for the rest of their lives. Barbara Carl Winstead passed away at the age of 59 at SBC or SECU Hospice House in Smithfield. Barbara was born on March the 24th, 1963, at the Marine Corps base at Camp Lejeune. She was born to Joseph Wesley Carr and Edith Britt Carr Lee. Barbara did not have what I will call the greatest of childhood, nor did her brothers and sisters. Her dad, from what I understand, I never got the chance to meet him, but I understand he was a very tough man. And sometimes as kids, we can't understand a dad and tough love. Barbara overcame that. She became a mother. A very loving mother, I'll say. She became a grandmother to four very, very beautiful grandchildren. Nolan, I hope you and Eli and Alyssa and Amberlynn know just how much your grandmother loves you. Let me say today, she's better off. She's no longer suffering. Jesus once said Let us not love in words, but in deeds and truth. Your presence here today shows your love indeed. But do not let it end today, a week, a month, a year from now. This family is still going to need you. My best advice that I can give to everybody in this room today, family and friends, are three simple words that begin with the letter H. First one, hush. Don't feel like you have to give the family answers for Barbara's death. There are simply some answers that we will never receive on this side of eternity. Even if we did have an explanation, it wouldn't bring Barbara back to us or heal the pain that we have in our hearts right now. Second, hear. Listen to them. Listen to their stories of Barbara. As we meet after the graveside service in at home, listen to their stories about Barbara. Listen to their hurt, their memories, and their pain. Calmly, patiently, listen. And third, and probably most important, hug. Give them a shoulder to cry on, a hug to help them through these troubled times. There once was an elderly man who lost his wife. As he sat on the porch crying, the little 4-year-old boy from next door went over and he sat in his lap. Later on, his mom asked him what he had said to him. And he replied quite simply, "Nothing, Mom. I just helped him cry." I think that's what the family needs more than anything, is for us to be there for them. And if they feel the need to cry, let them cry. We have all been touched by Barbara Winstead's life and story. And each of us feels lost deeply. But we can't change what has happened. The important thing is that we learn from Barbara's passing about what we need to know about ourselves, about life, and about God. When we are faced with uncertainty all around us, I think it's important that we turn to what we are certain of, and there are some things that we can be certain of today, young. Barbara loved her family. Even during the times in her life, which didn't go maybe the way she would have wanted it to, she loved you three children. And she loved spending time with them. She dearly loved each of her grandchildren. She loved her sister, Jenny. I think about the times they spent talking and relaxing, sitting at the beach. I know that's times my wife will never forget. That's treasured moments today. She truly loved her nieces, her nephews, and her family. I guess I should at this point say this family had some extra dynamics because of the timing under which Barbara's children were born and my wife's girls were born. They weren't really cousins. They were all sisters. They were all sisters. I think I see Heather and Josie both shaking their heads. My wife shaking their head. Hope, Shannon, Amy, they were all sisters.
They didn't call her Aunt Barbara or Uncle Ernie. It was Aunt or Uncle. They just knew.
They were all truly close.
They just knew.
And during those times when I mentioned that maybe Barbara didn't quite have things the way they should be, Jenny was able to step in. My wife was telling me about a time when somebody asked Ernie, "How many children do you have?" He said, "I've got six." They've got six. That's a blessing, y'all. Not all families have that. Second thing was, Barbara loved her friends. If she met you and she liked you, she loved you. There's no doubt of that. But I think the most important that I've got to emphasize, Barbara loved God. And I promised my wife and the girls that I was going to do anything but preach a fire and brimstone message up here today, and I hope I haven't done that. But I have to point out the fact that in my heart, I know that Barbara Winstead left this earth and truly loved God. My friends, God is with us each today here in this room. Whether we accept Him or not, He's here, He's with us, no matter what. Today, in the midst of our sadness, we can take comfort in the fact that Barbara is with Jesus. And when all is said and done, that's all that matters in this life. Now we're going to have another song that her daughter Josie picked out.
Oh,
That's another beautiful song. I'm sitting there listening to it and I feel compelled just to say this. If you intend to see her again, you too have to have your hearts right with God. We all do. We can't live on the edge. We have to either commit or we have to sit down. I was trying to come up with something for a reading, and it was very hard. But something finally came to me. Some of you may find it to be strange, but I think it fits very good. This is from a book by an author by the name of Khalil Gibran. The book is called The Prophet. The prophet in this book was being questioned by priests about everything from birth, life, marriage, love, death, blessings, and many other things. This is what it says in reference to death. Then our matron, the priestess, spoke, saying, "We would ask now of death." And the prophet said, "You would know the secret of death, but how shall you find it unless you seek it in the heart of life? If you would indeed behold the spirit of death, open your heart wide unto the body of life. For life and death are one, even as the river and the sea are one. Your fear of death is but the trembling of the shepherd when he stands before the king whose hand is laid upon him in honor. For what is it to die but to stand naked in the wind and melt in the sun? And what is it to cease breathing but to free the breath from its restless body, that it may rise and expand to seek God? Only when you drink from the river of silence can you indeed sing. And when you have reached the mountaintop, then you shall begin your climb. And when the earth shall claim your limbs, then you shall truly dance. Today, the winds bid me to leave you. Less hasty am I than the wind, but I must go. Brief were my days among you, and briefer still the words that I have spoken. But should my voice fade in your ears, and my love vanish in your memory, then I will come again. And with a richer heart and lips more yielding to the Spirit will I speak to you. Yes, I shall return with the tide, and though death may hide me, and a greater silence enfolds me, yet again will I seek your understanding. And not in vain will I seek. If what I have said is truth, that truth shall reveal itself in a clearer voice, and in words more kin to your thoughts. I go with the wind today, my loved one, but not down into emptiness." If we can have a word of prayer. Dear God, we ask that you heal the broken hearts here today and bind up their wounds. Mercifully look upon those who are at this time bereaved. Be near them in their sorrow, and let their sorrow draw them nearer to you, Lord. Now that earthly joys and comforts fail, may the things unseen and eternal grow more real and more present, more full of meaning and power. Let your strength sustain your weakness, and your peace fill their minds with perfect trust in you, through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen.
Thank you, folks. You're dismissed out of the back of the chapel. Have a blessed day.
I don't know.